The Red Cross was never able to get into the penal colony in Olenivka, in the occupied part of the Donetsk region, despite the ultimatum of Kyiv. The organization was given 3 days, which expired on October the 18th. The International Committee, according to its powers, is obliged to check the places of detention of prisoners. The organization says that they are ready to leave at any moment, but they cannot.
Our team is already in Donetsk. It has been there for a long time and is ready to visit people in Olenivka or in some other places of detention on any day. If it's today, it's today. Tomorrow, tomorrow. There are 11 people, among them a doctor. That is, the whole team is fully prepared to pay this visit. The only thing we need is to be given permission and some minimum security guarantees. Oleksandr Vasenko, spokesperson of the International Committee of the Red Cross in Ukraine, in a comment to Hromadske.
After such a response, Ukraine demanded the Red Cross officially declare that the main reason for the impossibility of finding out how Ukrainians are treated in Russian captivity is the lack of security guarantees from the Federation itself. Kyiv, for its part, strictly fulfills all its obligations to allow international humanitarian organizations to visit captive Russian military, the commissioner of the Verkhovna Rada of Ukraine for Human Rights says.
The problem with the International Committee of the Red Cross is that under the guise of neutrality, they do not want to call a spade a spade. If the Russian Federation does not give you security guarantees, then the only thing that Ukraine requires is that you publicly say that Russia doesn't provide you with security guarantees. And that is why you cannot arrive in Olenivka, Donetsk, Gorlivka, in all places where our prisoners of war and civilian hostages are kept, where the so-called filtration takes place.
Dmytro Lubinets believes that the United Nations can become an alternative to the Red Cross mission. The organization has a committee and a high commissioner for human rights, and the mandate of the United Nations allows visit to places of detention of prisoners of war and civilian hostages. The UN coordinator in Ukraine says that the problem lies exclusively with the Russian side, which does not even allow it to approach the front line. We're just not able to get, as of yet, access to that population. So I'm incredibly worried about them during the winter month. Millions of people are right now beyond our reach in these areas, and it's out of our reach right now. But the fact is that we regularly request access across the front line from both countries. Unfortunately, the Russian Federation has not yet granted us that access. Denise Brown, United Nations Resident Coordinator in Ukraine, in an interview with Voice of America. At a meeting with the new president of the International Committee of the Red Cross, Mirjana Ege, representatives of Russia assured that there were simply too many Ukrainian prisoners and therefore it was difficult to get to them.
We told the Red Cross that we will continue cooperating with them on this. But you must imagine that we have more than 6,000 Ukrainian prisoners. And sometimes it's not possible to organize all visits.
By the way, Kyiv has not confirmed these figures, and it is not known where the ambassador got them from. Russia continues to flagrantly violate the Geneva Convention. The duty of each party to the military conflict is to provide access to prisoners, to comply with all rules of detention, and to report transfers. In Russian captivity, people are tortured, beaten, starved, denied medical assistance, and forbidden to correspond with relatives. This information is provided by Ukrainians released from captivity. We were mocked. We were beaten. They are non-humans, just really bad people. Our women were beaten, and their women beat us the most. We were in a lot of places. We were in Taganrog and in Valuyki, Belgorod region, and in Kursk region. We were dragged almost all over Russia, so to speak. If you only knew how our boys are tortured there, they mock them very much, very brutally. Deputy Prime Minister, Minister for Reintegration of the Temporarily Occupied Territories of Ukraine, Irina Vereshchuk, report that more than 2,000 Ukrainians who are prisoners of war and civilians remain in Russian captivity. Reported by Diana Kolesnik, Yulia Basborodko, UATV News.